Well, we've got these nice new Heavy Body Acrylics, System 3 acrylics, and I've primed up a piece of canvas, a 2030, with some magenta. Now I've got to put out those paints into a new stay wet palette I've just developed here, a big old sandwich box, and we're going to paint this picture here using this Heavy Body texture and the techniques that we've been talking about of almost impressionist large brushwork and loose brushwork. And just see how it goes on this particular painting. Try these heavy bodies out. First of all, I'm just going to draw out with a little bit of blue pastel. This is one of the nicest SAA pastels. They're a very, very good price for value for money. And something I said earlier on was about painting loosely is that you want a fairly good drawing, not absolutely tight, but all the basic angles and proportions need to be correct before you start painting loosely, I think. Otherwise you'll find that if you paint loosely in a bad drawing, it enhances the bad things. So we need to have a reasonable drawing to work loosely within. Well, now for the fun then. We've got the palette, new palette laid out. Look, lovely bright new thick colours. My flat brush is ready here. Water, palette to mix. And back up to my magenta painted canvas. And we'll have a go at this picture of this market scene, French market scene, in this style of painting heavy body. Well, there we are, we've completed that one. And I'm quite happy with it really, as a start in this new series. It's carrying on with the Secret series, and I'm using perhaps a bit more colour now, and this heavier body, which is giving me a much brighter effect. I want to varnish this and see what difference that gives, because that'll bring out some colour as well. If you look more closely at it, you can see how loosely it's been worked, and I want to really push these colours. It's nice having a coloured ground as well, as you can see. So I'm going to do an autumn woodland one next with a red ground. Well, I looked at it a bit more, and I just decided I want to do just a bit more work on it. Just want to make this foreground a bit more slab-like somehow. I'm not quite happy with it. Got one colour on your brush, you can see it somewhere else and you missed it. Didn't go back and just pick it up again. Balancing one thing to another here, this with that. Blue grey. And we'll start to bring that into play in amongst these. How about a nice bright red orange under there? Hopefully I've improved on that version just a bit and just added a bit more to that foreground.